Hello, my dear students. Today we are going to learn the Tiger King. But before we go into this story, let me ask you, how do you treat animals? Like this or like this? Students, today's chapter is based on animal cruelty. Therefore, I had to show this in order to make you all realize how we treat animals. Some are very passionate about them and some treat them just like an inanimate object. So let us find out what Kalki wants to convey through this story. Before that, let's look into the biography of the writer. Kalki's real name is Ramaswamy Krishnamurthy. He was born on 9th September 1899 and died on 5th December 1954. He is very eminent Tamil writer, journalist, poet, critic, and Indian independence activist. His writings include over 120 short stories, 10 novellas, 5 novels, 3 historical romances, editorial and political writings, and hundreds of film and music reviews. In almost all the works, we find his rare quality of taking the reader back to the point and time of history when the story is supposed to have taken place. His historical work includes Parthiban Kannavu, Sivagamayin Sapatham, Punnayin Selvan, Solaimalai Illavarasi. His social novel includes Kalvanin Kaddali, Thiyaga Bhumi, Mugadhapathi, Abalayin Kanira, Alai Osai, Devagin Kanavan, Mohini Thevo, Poiman Karadu, Punnai Vanathu Puli, Amarathara, etc. In order to honor him, Tamil government has issued a postage stamp. Kalki Krishnamurthy also received the Sangeetha Kalasikhamani Award conferred on him by the Indian Fine Art Society in 1953. Students, now we will start with the theme of the story, and there are 3 prominent themes which runs throughout the story, and these are: destiny is all-powerful and inevitable, next one is animal abuse, the third one is crime and punishment. Students, the story transports the readers to the days of autocratic and very eccentric kings who dominated their subjects or ministers, but they themselves were extremely fearful of the British rulers. Students, let's start with the story now. The Tiger King. Let's see the heading first. It is extremely appropriate because entire life of the king. Okay, there is no particular name which is given to the king, but he is called by the Tiger King, right? So the Tiger King's motive of entire life revolves around tiger. Not only his life, but even his death is connected with tiger. Therefore, the title is appropriate. Let me read out the lines of the story. The Maharaja of Pratibandhapuram is the hero of this story. He may be identified as His Highness Zamindar General Kiledar Major Satavyagra Samhari Maharaja Dhiraja Vishwabhuvana Samrata Sir Jilani Jang Jang Bahadur MAD ACTC or CRCK, but this name is often shortened to the Tiger King. Students, here there is a king of Pratibandhapuram who has been given lots and lots of hi-fi titles by the writer. But finally, he comes back to Tiger King. It is because throughout the life of Tiger King, he was chasing tiger. He was killing tiger. Okay, throughout his life, he was thinking about tiger. Therefore, his name is appropriate. And remember, students, by all these hi-fi titles, the writer has no intention of praising the king. He might be having these titles, but he did not utilize Even if he had quality of becoming general, khiledar, major, he did not utilize the quality for the betterment of his country or countrymen. Students, here we find literary device anti-climax. It is because, first of all, the writer addresses him with a variety of titles, and just after that he brings an anticlimax by telling the readers that his name is shortened to the Tiger King. Students, in this chapter you have to be very patient because there are so many things that we need to discuss in details. All right, so let us not be in hurry. Let's understand one by one. Let's move further, students. I have come forward to tell you why he came to be known as Tiger King. I have no intention of pretending to advance only to end in a strategic withdrawal. Even the threat of a Stuka bomber will not throw me off track. The Stuka, if it likes, can beat a hasty retreat from my story. Students, Stuka bomber was a German ground attack aircraft which was known for its accuracy and terrorizing its enemy. Now, through the reference of this Stuka bomber, the author wants to convey that he intends to tell why Maharaja of Pratibandhapuram came to be known as Tiger King, and nothing, not even horrifying Stuka bomber, could compel him to deviate from the topic. Students, literary device exaggeration is used here because he exaggerates his narration. Let's move ahead. Right at the start, it is imperative, it is vital to disclose a matter of vital importance about the Tiger King. Everyone who reads of him will experience the natural desire to meet a man of his indomitable courage face to face, but there is no chance of its fulfillment. As Bharata said to Rama about Dasaratha, the Tiger King has reached the final abode of all living creatures. In other words, the Tiger King is dead. Students, the writer says that after knowing Tiger King, we will have a natural temptation to meet him face to face, but there is no possibility because the Tiger King is already reached to his final abode. Just like Dasaratha was dead and it was his demise, information was given to Rama by Bharata. In the same manner, the demise of Tiger King is being given to the readers by the author. Let's move to next. The manner of his death is a matter of extraordinary interest. It can be revealed only at the end of the tale. The most fantastic aspect of his demise was that as soon as he was born, astrologers had foretold that one day the Tiger King would actually have to die. The child will grow up to become the warriors of warriors, hero of heroes, champion of champions, but they bit their lips and swallowed hard. When compelled to continue, the astrologers came out with it. This is a secret which should not be revealed at all, and yet we are forced to speak out. The child born under this star will one day have to meet its death. At that very moment, a miracle took place. An astonishing phrase emerged from the lips of the 10-day-old Jilani Jang Jang Bahadur. O wise prophets! Students, the narrator says that the death of the Tiger King is more interesting than his life. When he was born, royal astrologers, they predicted that the child has to die one day. We readers know that there is no new thing in that, because whoever has come on earth, they have to die sooner or later, right? When he was forced, the astrologers said that he is going to be very famous, he is going to be courageous, he is going to be hero of heroes, warrior of warriors, champion of champions, but something stops the astrologers. Students, after this, the astrologers did not want to reveal the secret, but here supernatural thing happened, and that was A child, a prince of barely 10 days, speaks, and it shows that he had extraordinary powers. Let's read further, students. The chief astrologer placed his finger on his nose in wonder. A baby, barely 10 days old, opens its lips in a speech. Not only that, it also raises intelligent question. Incredible. Rather like the bulletin issued by the war office than facts. Indeed, the child had asked very intelligent question. Here Kalki makes this comparison mockingly. He actually means the newborn Tiger King's speaking skills were not only amazing, but they were as rhetoric as the artistry of news speakers of war bulletin. In short, he was praising newly born Tiger King's stunning ability to speak so clearly and intelligently. Let's move ahead. The chief astrologer took his finger off his nose and fixed his eyes upon the little prince. The prince was born in the hour of the bull. The bull and the tiger are enemies. Therefore, death comes from the tiger, he explained. You may think that Crown Prince Jung Jung Bahadur was thrown into a quick when he heard the word tiger. That was exactly what did not happen. As soon as he heard it pronounced, the Crown Prince gave a deep growl. Terrifying words emerged from his lips. Let tigers beware. This account is not only a rumor rife in Pratibandhapuram, but with hindsight, we may conclude it was based on some truth. Students, even after knowing the prediction about his death, the little prince was not at all fearful. Rather, he growled, okay, let tigers beware. Now, it shows that the little prince is ready to challenge even tigers, but he is not going to be fearful at all. And the same he proved in his future. Students, here the state astrologer believes that the hour of the bull, that is Taurus, the sign under which the prince is born, and the tiger, that is Leo, are inimical towards each other. So the prince should beware of tigers. The king's death through a tiger shows that Kalki believes in astrology. Very soon the news became widespread, and even the readers must accept that there is some truth in the prediction. Students, we have completed the first part of the story. Now we will move to the part 2. Crown Prince Jung Jung Bahadur grew taller and stronger day by day. No other miracle marked his childhood days apart from the event already described. The boy drank the milk of an English cow, was brought up by an English nanny, tutored in English by an Englishman, saw nothing but English films, exactly as the crown princes of all the other Indian states did. When he came of age at 20, the state, which had been with the court of wards until then, came into his hands. But everyone in the kingdom remembered the astrologer's prediction. Many continued to discuss the matter. Slowly it came to the Maharaja's ears. Students, the story was written when India was under the governance of Britishers. At that period, Indian rulers had given utter importance to English. They had followed English lines. Okay, the way it is described out here, the way bringing up of the Tiger King described out here, it shows that English was given utter importance. And it is so ironical that being an Indian king, he was not able to safeguard his own culture, and he happily accepted English way of life. So author here satirizes and ridicules the attitude of Indian royalty. Students, still English is there in our life. Even after independence, we are not able to do away with this language. And another very pathetic thing is that our intelligence is being judged by the knowledge of this language, which is very catastrophic for our culture. So we need to understand that it is just a language and not a measurement of our intelligence. And as far as possible, we should opt for our language and we should keep English just for earning bread and butter, because our language gives us identity, which we have learned in the first chapter, that is the last lesson. We should not forget that. We should never forget our mother tongue, because through mother tongue, our identity will be preserved. Students, when the prince grew up, the throne of Pratibandhapuram was given to him. Prior to that, it was being governed by his guardians. And gradually, the prediction which was made years ago became active again. And it came into the ears of Maharaja. Let's move to the next slide, students. There were innumerable forests in the Pratibandhapuram state. They had tigers in them. The Maharaja knew the old saying, "You may kill even a cow in self-defense." There could certainly be no objection to killing tigers in self-defense. The Maharaja started out on a tiger hunt. Students, now we see the ruthless and callous nature of Tiger King towards innocent animals. He says that he may kill a cow in self-defense, but had they harmed Tiger King? Had cow come to kill a Tiger King, or it was he himself who had gone to the forest and killed numerous tigers? So he had molded this saying according to his appropriateness, and which we find unreasonable and illogical. Move to the next paragraph. The Maharaja was thrilled beyond measure when he killed his first tiger. He sent for the state astrologer and showed him the dead beast. "What do you say now?" he demanded. "Your Majesty, you may kill 99 tigers in exactly the same manner, but," the astrologer drawled. "But what? Speak without fear. But you must be very careful with the 100th tiger. What if the 100th tiger were also killed? Then I will tear up all my books on astrology, set fire to them, and I shall cut off my tuft, crop my hair short, and become an insurance agent." The astrologer finished on an incoherent note. Students, here we must understand that tuft is the identity of Brahmin. And he said that he will cut off his tuft. That means he will lose his identity, which is very big thing. And he will become an insurance agent. Okay, it shows that his prediction is extremely perfect. Whatever he has predicted, that is going to happen. Therefore, he very confidently says that he is going to change his identity and take up another job if his prediction will be proved incorrect. Since part 3 is a bit lengthier, therefore, we will start with third part in our next video. Till then, take care. Bye-bye.